So today we're going to look at bromine. So this is bromine. It's a small sample, about 2 or 3 grams.
Yeah, bromine is a red liquid. There are not many elements that are actually liquid. Cesium, mercury, gallium, and bromine. It's this beautiful red colour, and it has an unpleasant smell. Bromine comes from the Greek word bromos, which means a stench, a really horrible smell.
In fact, this bromine probably comes from near where I did my degree, because in Europe, the largest producer of bromine in Europe is the Octel company, which is based on Amluch on Anglesey, and it's actually where I went last weekend. So it's a nice sample. We're going to get it out of this bottle now. It's sealed in because it's obviously very, very volatile as a liquid, and we're going to cut the glass, get it out, and then look at its chemistry. Thanks, Neil.
Bromine is also quite a common element in the world. It is found in seawater as bromide. It's also found particularly in the Dead Sea between Israel and Jordan, where there are very concentrated solutions of bromide. So you can make bromine just by bubbling chlorine into a solution of bromide, like Dead Sea water, and the chlorine displaces the bromine and forms chloride, and the bromine just comes out as red fumes, which you can catch.
So Neil's now using a glass knife to open the ampoule, and he's going to pour the liquid bromine into this small evaporating dish inside our fume hood. Now instantly you can see the vapour of the bromine coming off. You see all these really nice orange fumes which are coming off from the liquid, and then they're being drawn away by our fume hood.
Bromine has a number of uses. It is particularly used in plastics as an additive to try and make them less flammable. If you're watching your videos on a screen which has a plastic surround, almost certainly that surround will contain bromine to make it less flammable.
Bromine itself is strongly oxidizing, so we thought we'd do an oxidation reaction today. And that reaction is to take another element, and here we have aluminium, simple aluminium foil, like you wrap your dinner in. And we're now going to put some small amounts of aluminium foil into the bromine liquid. So we'll put it in, and it generally takes a few moments for this reaction to start. But as I said, the aluminium is strongly oxidizing. It oxidizes and generates aluminium tribromide, which is a beautiful, nice material, but it's a strongly exothermic reaction. So let's see what happens now. This may initiate.
It is also an unusual element because elements have different isotopes. These are the same form of the element, but with different numbers of neutrons in the atoms, so they weigh different amounts. Usually you get one isotope that is very common and another one that is only a small amount. Bromine is unusual because it has two isotopes, 79 and 81, which have almost equal quantities in nature, so that they're approximately 51% of one and 49% of the other, which is really quite unusual.
So here we see the exothermic oxidation and formation of aluminium tribromide. So the reaction is strongly exothermic, which means it gives out energy, and that energy then evaporates off excess bromine, which you can see coming off of the vapour. A wonderful exothermic reaction, very, very fast, very, very rapid, forming aluminium tribromide.
Bromine is quite dangerous, but it is less dangerous than chlorine because it's a liquid at room temperature. Chlorine is a gas, so if you let out chlorine, it disperses everywhere. With bromine, it is a heavy gas which can disperse rather more slowly.
So now, as the reaction cools down, we can see that the volume of bromine is significantly reduced.
Reacts with water quite well.